everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name's Kate, and this is Ethnobotanicam. Today, we're talking about apples.
But can I eat it?
Now, you might be saying to yourself, what could possibly be spooky and whatnot with the apples? They're known to ward off illness with the apple a day keeps the doctor away thing. They are associated with knowledge. And man's fall from grace and into general animalian tendencies. They have mystical properties. If you cut an apple crossways instead of vertically, it forms a star with the seeds. There's all kinds of associations. There's different species. There's hundreds of different species. They each have their own properties. But there's one that is known as the little apple of death, Manzanilla de la Muerte, the Manchineel, or Manchineel, depending where you are. It has small fruits, is native to the Caribbean, Florida, the Bahamas, Mexico, and Central and Northern South America. The scientific name of this tree is Hippomane Manchineel. In its native territory, it grows in coastal beaches and kind of brackish swamp areas like mangroves, and is known to keep the soil together and prevent erosion, so it stabilizes the land that it's on and provides natural windbreaks. It's got kind of a reddish-grayish bark and green-yellow flowers that are pretty small and shiny green leaves. But it grows to like 15 meters or 49 feet tall. The only mention that I found of its prevalence, really, was that it's endangered in Florida. Now, what could be so bad about this tree? All parts are toxic. All parts. If you properly dry the wood, it can be used to make very nice furniture. But all parts are toxic, to the extent that if you happen to find yourself standing under this tree when it rains, the sap from the tree can cause intense skin lesions and massive pain and blisters. If you should happen to get it in your eyes, it can cause blindness, temporary in most cases, sometimes permanent. It damages paint on cars, and a lot of the toxins present haven't been identified yet. It contains formal but a lot of the components we don't yet know scientifically. It also causes intense vomiting and diarrhea if ingested, and can lead to death. Most care administered if you go into an emergency room after consuming this or having exposure is just like maintenance care, and you have to wait it out. However, one of the traditional treatments for the blisters, at least, is to make an arrowroot poultice, and that's supposed to mitigate the toxicity and irritation caused by the blisters to help it heal easier and faster. Now, from an ethnobotanic perspective, there's been a number of uses for the plant aside from making furniture from the wood. That's a really big one, but you have to dry the wood until all the sap is gone. Otherwise, you're just gonna poison everybody that comes in contact with it, with severe dermatitis, among other things. So the sap, because of its potency, has been used to tip poison arrows in a lot of native communities. It's been used as timber for centuries, and the gum, or the cortex, has been used in modern medicine to treat edema. And the dried fruits can sometimes be used as a diuretic, but only, I would suggest, under extreme supervision of a medical professional that knows how that plant reacts to your system and whatever else you're taking. Would not suggest to just go harvest it yourself. According to reports, when it's first ingested, it tastes kind of nicely sweet, but then there's severe pain and potential death, so. So, can you eat the Manchineel? I wouldn't suggest it. Can you eat the regular ones? Oh yeah. Till next week. See you later, guys. It's got reddish sort of green...